very much, Larry. We are here on a beautiful afternoon for football. Today, we're set for a good AFC matchup between the Indianapolis Colts and the Buffalo Bills. Hi again, everyone. I'm Brandon Gordon. Welcome to the NFL on EA Sports. With me as always, the wide receivers, often a very, very talented group, and that's the case here.
And they don't mind showcasing it either. Those guys love to be flashy, love to make big plays out in the open field. They will attempt to...
And here's a look at the defensive unit that hopes to hold this offense today. Some big threats at wideout.
And they seem to get bigger all the time, don't they, Brandon? Every time I look out and watch a game, we're getting these bigger, more athletic, acrobatic receivers.
Third and seven. There's the 11 starters on defense for Buffalo, and the new coaching staff really coming in. They can look at two numbers, kind of yin and yang. They're good against the pass, sixth in the league, 29th, though, against the run.
But if you look at this new coaching staff that has taken over at Buffalo, and trade guys that you trust the most with the ball, the biggest playmakers you have, if they touch it on this possession to try and get things moving.
So it's caught inside the 30. A big play here for Buffalo. 45 yards. Well, we know he's got the speed there. He needed the speed and the hands. A great catch.
And because of that speed, you have to respect it as a defender. So you have to either play off or make sure you're somehow in contact with him. And he's able to do exactly what you said. Use the speed to his advantage and go up and get the football.
And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. And he is into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown. A great effort there. An 18-yard touchdown run. And the Bills have taken the early lead.
I know we don't talk about it enough, but the intelligence level of the guys up front blocking, the offensive linemen, maybe the smartest guys in football overall. Athleticism and a whole lot of toughness, you got a lot to deal with, don't you?
That's what. And they'll run it here. It's a 9-yard gain and it keeps the drive moving.
It's a good, nice, crisp run for a first down. I wonder if the defense might have been loosened up a little bit, maybe anticipating a pass instead of the run that they got.
And on the ground they go with the running back. Joke. He's got some space now. And a nice carry there of 15 yards.
He's quite an eyeful, isn't he? Big, strong, physical guy. When he came out of school and when I looked at my draft board, I went back through my notes to see how I had him rated. The number two back on my board coming out of college. Why? As I mentioned, big, strong, powerful guy.
And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. And he gets it to the 32, good enough for a first down. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs.
Third and one, partner. No need to be fancy there. Just use some force and move forward and pick up.
Now they'll switch it up here. And he's wrapped up, taken down, back at the 25. The corner blitz pays off there as they sack him for a loss of 5. He'll look to throw. Looking for his tight end on the corner. It's complete. They give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs.
And the game just keeps evolving. Big guys running those corner routes, so difficult to cover.
The handoff as they run the counter play. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains.
I don't want to downplay the run, but that's exactly what I expected out of him coming out of college. When I look back at my draft analysis, one of the highest-rated players on my board, a three-down back who could do everything, and one of the best...
Now a shotgun snap is in, and he takes this one in for a Colts touchdown. Their big-bodied receiver from 10 yards out, and the Colts have taken the lead. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts, all right? Because once he took off, I mean, let's face it. That should have been done in Big Sky Country. Ernest
and Banks in the game. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. Wide open receiver complete. A pretty good mark there. They needed 14. They got 14 on third down. He's such a good route runner. Back to throw now on first down. McKinner here. It's complete. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
Didn't they tell us in our meetings that they needed to account for him on each and every play?
You think a guy of his caliber? So how does a guy like him get that one? Offense working with a second and goal now from the three. And he takes it in across the chalk for a Bills touchdown. A great play there with his second touchdown here this first half. And the Bills have retaken the lead. And always a good first half when you can hit pay dirt twice.
And it never hurts to have that good feeling as the game moves on. Just think about halftime. If that's is all he gets, he'll just sit there at the half and think, all right, two already. I can get some more.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And he's got his man on the out route. 15 yards there on the catch and run.
No matter how you evaluate, I'm really impressed by what I saw on that throw on the out route.
New Orleans, Cleveland, Minnesota, Rams, and Arizona. Those in London.
The Colts town will probably feel like they should be doing better on the scoreboard.
All right, let's do it. Here's a look at the first half highlights. Bills with possession early in the first. The quick pass and completion is made, and the play will come to an end after a gain of 45. Bills later on the drive, hand off the run goes up the middle. He'll run it in from 19 yards out. That takes the lead up to 7. Third and 7. He'll cough up the ball after the catch. On the field now after the fumble. The pass complete out of the gun. And it leads to a touchdown. The Colts up by a field goal. Fields line up at the 3. This run will go up to the left side and he'll go in for the 3-yard touchdown. The Bills go up by 4. So that'll do it for us here in Orlando. On the call of the second half, let's hand it back over to Brandon and Charles. Brandon.
Talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission.
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. Time to the tailback. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks. And third quarter here, you've got the lead. This is where that strong run game can really benefit you. State inbounds or get the clock going.
I like all the points you just made there. And if you throw the football and it's incomplete, now you stop the clock and you've helped.
Switch it up here and look to throw. He's got time. Hit from behind and he's going to be driven down. It'll go as a loss of about 6 and now it brings up third.
And this is something in a 3-4 you don't normally get because the nose tackle who got the sack, he's usually responsible or ends up getting double teamed and sometimes triple teamed. How about him working his way back and putting the big guy on the ground?
He's going to wind up and air it out. And got his man complete. A really good pickup of 28 yards. A great job pulling that one in from a guy, as we know, who can really blaze. He's got a lot of speed.
And that speed can work for him so many different ways. Sometimes he just takes off and goes, just runs past people. Sometimes you get people to back off so far that you can catch everything underneath.
Shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Looking left side, it's complete. He's got it. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs. And boy, they had high praise for this rookie receiver when we asked the coaches about him, didn't they?
They certainly did, and obviously they liked his neck.
Here we go now.
And they'll turn to the power game and try to get in. And he'll get in. Touchdown, Buffalo. It's the fullback taking it in. And the Bills will extend their lead. Well, they weren't messing around. First and goal. They don't do anything fancy. They just go to the fullback right away.
I like how you phrase that, because oftentimes they come back to the fullback when it's late in the down and distance count, right? And this kid's first. Carrying the ball, but how about that big mass of humanity that guided him to that spot?
Yeah, they got there, but I love the dive. Always a fan of the dive. Bills offense now, they get set to head back on the field. That last drive, it's a good mix. Run, pass, run. The play action fake, they'll look to throw. And he finds a man on the crossing route. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. A good pickup there of 20 yards.
And when an offense is doing a nice job selling the play-action pass, a lot of responsibility shifts to the linebackers. They're the ones that have to determine run or pass and get to the proper places on the field. Touchdown of the game.
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. He's got time in the pocket. Gonna throw right side here, complete. Oh no, he lost the football. And I think the offense got it back. They did. Inside the 10-yard line, they avoid disaster. But call it luck or skill, whatever the case is, they're feeling good about just keeping the football there.
Yeah, the biggest thing they're calling it now, our ball. We don't care if it was luck or skill.
They run the counter now on first down. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown. A great play there. A 10-yard touchdown run. And the Bills have taken the lead here in the fourth quarter. And how about that, giving us our fifth lead change of the game? It's been back and forth.
Looking at something out of central casting, frankly.
Absolutely. He's got the size, the hands.
Speed. I mean, can flat out run. You put that whole package together, you light up the eyes of an offensive coordinator, don't you?
Our sixth lead change of the game.
Are we back on the playground on the seesaw?
A little seesaw. chainsaw battle, right? Yeah.
Up and down, what a game we've watched here.
It's been fun.
Hey, here we go, green, 39.
They'll try to throw for it, and he's got it. So the two-point conversion is good, and they add on to their fourth quarter lead. So they make the decision, they want a three-point lead first
thing to do. Put a little pressure on your defense, but the biggest thing now is you're making the other team chase you.
Buffalo offense now as they get set to take over here. And that last drive.
Know the three is there. Don't do anything to jeopardize it. But take your shots to try and increase your lead.
On play action, they'll throw. That is caught inside the five. And they do stop him, but he takes it all the way to the two. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this position.
And they'll run it here. And he takes it in for a Colts score. A great effort there, punching it in from a yard away. And the Colts add on to their lead. And they're able to run it in. It started with a battle in the trenches. They won there, and they got in for 6 points.
And that's going to be a tough one for the defense to deal with. They've got to go to the bench now and figure out how we're going to slow down this running game, because on that particular means leverage on the guy trying to cover him. It is really, really tough for the defender to get through him to make a play on the football. That's why guys love to throw that route down the middle, throw it deep, and let the big guy go get it.
With that, the ball game is over. Going into the final play of this game, they knew that they needed some type of a miracle.
Even though they didn't finish it off, you're exactly right. They took us down to the last play. We're still, you're wondering, could it happen? Possibly, even though we both knew it was a long shot.
That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaunt. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL.